Oh, life could be a dream. Life could be a dream.
Yeah, it makes me very nostalgic.
Yeah, all the memories flood back.
Yeah, some of the greatest times of my life were spent in this pool with Winter and Abby.
Same for me. Like, I think one shot that I just is kind of my favorite shot I've ever done is the one where I'm going to the bottom and I spin up to the top with Winter holding her pectoral fins. It's just such an amazing experience to do that, and how silent it was too when it was happening. I could only hear her whistling. It was just such a surreal experience. Like, I can't believe it happened.
Right now, this is bringing me back. Yeah, exactly. You were just like, Phoebe, you tell her to do stuff. And I was like, really? And you were like, yeah. And I was like, okay. And then she listened to me and I was like, I just spoke to a dolphin. Like, we were filming and so I couldn't flip out because I was like, I had to be professional. I was like, yeah, this is supposed to happen. It's totally fine. I'm just a dolphin trainer. Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
I don't know if I'm like the only non-CMA employee to ever put on and take off her tail, but I think I'm definitely one of the few. And Winter, I have to give her a lot of props because she let me do a lot of these things and like responded to me when, you know, she didn't have to. I was extremely nervous, but luckily, look how cute she is. I mean, she's
oh my gosh, I could honestly watch this all day.
And then also the end of the movie where we're swimming with Winter and Hope and you and me. I mean, it was just to be underwater with the dolphins in that capacity. It was the only thing I wished had happened in the first movie. And, you know, we never knew we were going to have a sequel. And I was like, man, it just would have been so cool to be underwater with the dolphins. Because I actually never had that with the first movie. And so to have it in the second one, it was like very, very cool.
I hope you love her as much as I do. Because Winter and I are family now. And family is forever.
They always kind of wonder if we're friends in real life.
Yeah.
And the answer is no.
Nope.
Can't stand them.
Do this.
No, I mean, these are truly two of the most important people in my entire life. I love you guys so much.
Oh my gosh, Austin. What a special moment to capture on camera.
Austin and I call each other
sea stars.
They just call me Nathan. It's all right.
We are sea stars.
I'm good. That's your thing.
No, truly, this is special stuff right here.
Whenever I think about Winter, I think about the impact she has and the overall domino effect that she's had on the world. Because she's already an inspiring person.
Dolphin,
you're right. There's not some tiny person in there. she is such an inspiring dolphin. But the inspiration that people get from her, they feel the need to pass it on to other people. We've met so many kids, especially, who have been inspired by Winter, and they create their own foundation to help other kids that are like them. And their main inspiration was from Winter. And then kids from that foundation want to make their own. And then it's just this domino effect of inspiration and kids trying to go out there and push this message of, hey, you can fight this. You can fight this and we'll be right alongside with you.
Keeps going. I mean, most of the kids that we met today were not even born when we filmed the first movie 8 years
ago. That's weird.
Isn't that crazy?
That's weird to think.
Most of the kids that we met today were under 8 years old.
It's incredible.
That's what happens when it's a true story, you know what I mean? It never gets old.
We use movie magic all the time, but rarely for exciting reasons. It's mostly so that we make sure we don't hurt our rescued animals or put them in positions where they're not happy. So for instance, the rescue scene, it's an animatronic dolphin for that. It's actually crazy. I have amazing pictures of just like half a dolphin, like a robot dolphin. And when you see Nathan, who plays Sawyer, petting her at the beach, that is a robot dolphin. And what it took was like a crew of 10 men pushing and pulling on different things and winding mechanisms, all to make her move her head slightly and blink or like breathe through her blowhole. It's absolutely amazing. So cool.